Drive-by-wire throttle bodies have essentially become the norm in high-level race cars, particularly the ones we see here competing at World Time Attack. Now, while the drive-by-wire throttle body is a very refined and well-understood technology now, it's also a very safe technology. We can see some problems with drive-by-wire throttle bodies when they are exposed to high levels of vibration. Now, this particularly becomes an issue when we have an engine that is solid mounted, or maybe the engine mounts that are used still use a rubber mount, but one that is much stiffer than what we see in a factory application. What this can result in is vibration being transferred into the throttle body, and this can result in the drive-by-wire throttle body not following its target. And when this occurs, the ECU uses a built-in safety strategy to essentially put the drive-by-wire throttle body into fault. It closes the throttle, and obviously that's the end of your flying lap. One of the ways of getting around this problem is to actually install the throttle body in a way that's isolated from vibration. Easy way of doing this is to use a Wiggins or Plasma Man style clamp, both pre and post throttle body. So one between the throttle body and the intercooler plumbing like we traditionally see, but then a second clamp between the throttle body and the inlet manifold or plenum chamber. And what that does is just allows enough movement that the vibration is isolated and not transferred into the throttle body.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.